Hey everyone, welcome to Two Car Pros. My name is Ryan, and today we are doing part two of our how to build a Ford 5.4 liter three valve engine. So what's involved in today's video is taking off our timing set, our cylinder heads, our valve train, and that's pretty much it. I know it doesn't sound like too much, but it's a little bit special in this engine because it's overhead cam. Everything we've done so far is single cam in block, so effectively known as a pushrod engine. This doesn't have any pushrods, so it's a little bit different and a little more involved, but don't worry, I'm gonna show you exactly how to take it all apart, bolt by bolt. Before we go any further, let's go ahead and thank our awesome sponsor, Summit Racing. They are sending me so many great parts to finish off this build. We've worked with them on a bunch of different engines before. They are an outstanding sponsor. They have really great customer support, an awesome selection, great prices, and they always ship things out really quickly. So make sure you buy all your speed parts from summitracing.com. So let's focus on today of taking the valve, effectively the valve train and the heads off, and we will get to the bottom end on the next video that's coming very soon. So with all that out of the way, let's jump in. So before we start taking things apart, I thought I'd show what was making all of that racket when the engine was on. Check this out. That's the sound of, you know, a loose timing set. So what happens is this timing chain tensioner goes out. See how it's like compressed and I can move this out? It's supposed to be like that. So that way the thing has tension on the chain and this one doesn't. You can actually just move it freely and you shouldn't really be able to do that. It's supposed to be like that, and then it wouldn't have any of this nasty slack. So that's our sound. That's why this sounds like a diesel truck. And eventually what will happen is this will whip around so many times that the timing chain guides will just bust up and be ruined, and most likely ruin the entire block. So I'm glad we caught this when we did. And then we can remove the sensor wheel for the crankshaft positioning sensor. You can just pull it straight off. Hold on to this. This is a non-wear item. We'll probably just reuse it. And we can remove our cam phaser with a 15 millimeter socket, removing this bolt. And the phaser should be held in place by the tension on the timing chain. Let me just buzz that off. Remove that guy. And these will come with a new one with our new cam phasers, so don't reuse this bolt. Now we can remove the two 10 millimeter bolts holding on the timing chain tensioner. Guide might come out with it. And then for this lower guide, there's no actual bolt, it just kind of slides off. And what I want you to do with these is throw it right in the trash because we're gonna get new ones. So now we can remove our timing chain. So we just finish removing our timing chain. And what I want you to do with this is throw it directly into the trash. These are very used. They have 190,000 miles on them, thereabouts. And what happens is the slot for each individual pin gets bigger and bigger and bigger over the years. And eventually the chain stretches out and the engine won't be timed. It'll make all kinds of awful noises. And if it gets really bad, it can destroy the engine. So yeah, go ahead and get new ones. And for the cam phaser, you should just be able to kind of wiggle it and pull it straight toward you and off. And again, get new ones of these because these go out all the time. They are notorious for going out on this engine. It's not worth your time and money to put used bad parts back in. Just spend the money, get new ones. Then we can remove this other guide with the two 8 millimeter bolts. There we go. Get that guy out of there. And again, throw this piece of plastic in the trash and get new ones. So with the bolt holding the heater core hose removed, we can just kind of wiggle that toward you. Want to come straight back with it. You can wiggle that left and right while you work it backward. A little sticky. Ah, there we are. And we can just set that aside. So these two O-rings, I imagine, are really easy to forget about, and I bet they leak like a you-know-what if you don't replace them. So I'm gonna remove them right now, and that'll go all nice and clean when it's getting hot tanked at the machine shop. But don't forget to put those O-rings back because that'd be sure bare to get to while in the truck. The next thing we can do is remove the oil control solenoid. Technically, you don't need to remove it to remove the head, but I'm gonna go ahead and do it while it is still on the engine, 2 8 millimeters. We should be able to just pull that straight towards you. There you go. So the next thing we're gonna do is remove our cylinder head. This is really easy. You don't need to take the camshaft out. You just need to remove the 10 13 millimeter bolts. I'm just gonna use my half inch impact gun and buzz them off. And the way we're gonna take them off is in a reverse spiral. So I'm gonna kind of do this and you can just follow along. And these head bolts are junk. Wow, that's a really long head bolt. Go ahead and buy new ones. You don't want your whole next build to be reliant on old head bolts, and that could really ruin your day. And be careful as you're removing the last bolt. You don't want the thing to fall off and smash your toes. Just in case it falls off the dowel, you don't want it, finding your toe. It's quite heavy, even if it's made of aluminum. So, you know, maybe keep a hand on it. Usually they stay put, but you never know. So a lot of the time these are pretty stuck on there, and you don't want them to come off unexpectedly. So you can grab a long prying implement, stick it like right here, and just give it a little love to kind of break that seal. And then once that seal's broken, pull up and out straight like that and set it down, not with the head side on the ground, but on its back basically, or on its side rather. So you can set the cylinder head down like that. And now we can really look at the inside of our engine. This is where all the magic happens. Obviously here's our pistons. We can take our stock head gasket off and toss that into the trash. We're getting new ones. And then this gives you a good idea of what kind of shape your engine's in. This one's in pretty good shape. You want to check the sides of the bore for any kind of scoring. Could indicate a broken oil control ring or a compression ring on the piston. You want to check the ridge ream at the very top of where the rings come up, and kind of catch my fingernail a little bit on that. Not bad though, I have to say, looking inside of here, yeah, there's miles on this engine, but honestly, not bad. I've seen way worse. This is gonna shape up to be a really cool build. So the really good news is that this timing set and head are exactly the same. So just do the exact same thing for the driver's side. So let's talk about our cylinder heads now that they're off. I'm only gonna show you one because they're basically the same side to side. And we're just gonna prep them for the machine shop because I want these rebuilt, you know, put new valves in there with new valve springs and keepers. And, you know, I'm gonna put in the roller followers and camshaft. So I think what I'm gonna do is just take the camshaft off, take the roller followers out, and then it's essentially ready for the machine shop. But there's a special order you wanna go in when you're taking this camshaft off of here. You wanna go in reverse spiral, just like that. And what you can do is take your 10 millimeter socket, and we're just going to break them loose just a little bit, you know, like quarter turn, and then just keep going in the reverse spiral. Truth be told, these aren't on, you know, super tight or anything. So we go over here now. And you just repeat the process. Actually, these are already pretty loose. Oh, not these ones. Okay, those are under no pressure. Good. So they're pretty loose now. You can just back them all the way out.
Now, when you're taking these caps off, be careful because they are numbered and they're orientated. It's kind of tricky to see. You're really not going to be able to see on camera. I can barely see it in person, but like this one says number 4 and it has an arrow pointing this way. You can't mix any of those up. This cap has to go back on the exact same cap, site that you took it off at. We can just wiggle those back and forth and remove it straight up. I'm gonna set those aside. These don't have to go to the machine shop. These don't have to be machined at all. This is just fine. We can put them back in once the heads get back from their work. So this one was kind of cocked this way. Just pushed it that way, lift it up and out. And you can't mix up the caps head to head either. So these caps have to go back onto this cylinder head. Not quite. There we go. Then we can go ahead and remove our camshaft. I will be getting a new one because look how scored it is. Truthfully, you might be able to get away with putting it back in, but why do all this work and all this effort to put something used back in when it's a super critical engine part? I'm just gonna go ahead and get freshies. And then the roller followers come off really easy. If you miss that, you just pull straight up and take these and throw them directly into the trash and get new ones. So these engines are notorious for these roller followers going bad for this reason. It's kind of hard to tell, but there we go. The needle bearings inside of there go bad or sometimes even break. These are kind of okay, but I can tell they have a bit too much slop in them. I would not reuse these. The new updated version don't have those same bearings and don't have that problem. So we'll be using those when we put it back together. Like I said, throw these into the trash. So then we can remove the lifters as well. That's these, and there's 3 per cylinder. And these can collapse and go bad as well. So I toss these 2 and get new ones. This is not something you want to just, you know, cheap out on. This is really critical engine stuff, so you might as well spend the money and get something good. So fans of the channel might remember that I did that Ford 5.4 liter 3-valve spark plug job. I think that was back in 2018 or something. Anyway, where we took the spark plugs out of an F-150 from 2005, that is this exact truck. So it's good to see the old friend back. And before we take the spark plugs out, we're going to go ahead and use some compressed air. Blow the crud out of there. Yeah, looks pretty good. And I'm gonna take my own advice and spray some WD-40 down in there. Let that sit for just a minute. And then grab my 9/16 spark plug socket and put it on there. And the key for this, like I said all those years ago, is you wanna just kind of break it loose. And if it's like really fighting you and it feels like really crunchy and like craggly, go ahead and tighten it a little bit and then loosen it. So the procedure is to tighten it an eighth turn, loosen it a quarter turn, or thereabouts. You just kind of want to seesaw it off. And what that does is it preserves those threads, and then you don't break off spark plugs inside of your cylinder head. And that's that little tip for you on these Fords, which are known for doing that. And it'll come out just like I've done it. Look how easy that is. It comes out every time, easy as pie. Before we send this off to the machine shop, go ahead and look at the surface that the cam rides, and it's not a bearing, it's just kind of a machined surface. Make sure there's not some giant scores in it or something like that. If I'm not mistaken, that usually means that the head is ruined, but go ahead and check with your machinist if there's, I don't know, maybe something I can do, but typically you need a new cylinder head in that state. But these look okay by my estimation, so we're gonna go ahead and put the cap back on where they came off, and I'm just gonna leave them. You know, finger tight's fine. Doesn't need to be crazy on there. You just don't want them like snapping off or something. And the reason you're doing that is because they don't need any machine work or anything, but it'd be nice to get them hot tanked so they look nice and clean when they get back. Looking for number 2, that's this one. Luckily they're already labeled. If for some odd reason yours aren't labeled, go ahead and label them. But luckily mine are nice and labeled. I'm actually gonna do them sequentially. You don't need to at this point, but I'm going to anyway, because it's good practice to be in. So now the head is ready for the machine shop. And what we're going to have them do is we're gonna have them put in new valves, new springs, new keepers. We're gonna have it hot tanked so it's nice and cleaned. And then we're gonna have the part of the head that actually mates with the block machined flat. So we make sure that that is perfectly flat once again. And then this thing will be ready to be put back in, or on top of our engine rather. And the cool thing is, both cylinder heads are essentially the same, so do the same thing for the other one.
That is how to take your heads and valve train off of a Ford 5.4 liter three-valve engine. Again, a little more involved than we've seen in the past. Normally, I'm able to throw in the valve train with the bottom end, and it's no biggie because it's really simple just to remove rocker arms and push rods and lifters. This, again, is a little more involved, as you saw with roller followers and the cam just riding on a surface inside of the head. So it's a little different, and I pointed those differences out along the way. But it is very easy and approachable if you do it step by step and follow this video. Thank you so very much for watching. If you found this video helpful or interesting at all, please consider giving a like or even subscribing. It really helps my channel out. Thank you, Summit Racing, for sponsoring this video, and I'll see you next time.